Greetings, folks. Bill O'Leary, coming to you in this video to answer the question, what's the difference between family law and elder law? So what you're going to learn in this video is, what is family law, what is elder law, and what's the difference? So real quick, Bill O'Leary, I'm a lawyer with Legacy Planning Law Group, and what we do here in Jacksonville, Florida, is things like elder law, things like estate planning, wills, trusts, and estates, and probate and estate and trust administration. That's all we do. So let's jump right into the topic at hand. So what is the difference between family law and elder law? Although they sound similar, they in fact are quite different. So first, family law, what's that? It's a type of legal practice that focuses on many different sort of issues that involve family relationship, things like divorce. This is where each spouse is going to hire their own attorney. And by the way, most divorce cases never go to trial. Most of them just reach a settlement. And the divorce attorneys are very skilled at knowing how to divide marital property, how to calculate spousal support, and putting together, let's say, a plan for maybe child custody, child support, and visitation rights. So speaking of child custody and child support, this is also part of family law, and it's where, you know, a court is going to order one of the spouses to maybe step up or to provide child custody, child support. Maybe it's a shared obligation. Understand that once that sort of that court order is entered, initially, a lot of times it has to be revisited as conditions change. For example, child support may be altered, let's say after the non-custodial parent's financial situation changes, the parent that is does not have the children on a regular basis. Family attorneys deal with what's called paternity. This is usually where a mother files a paternity type legal case in an effort to sort of secure child support payments from an absent father. Although sometimes biological fathers will initiate the paternity case in order to be able to have a relationship with their child. And paternity usually is established by DNA testing, okay? Another thing that family law attorneys do is adoption, foster care. And adoption, it's a sort of a complex process that differs according to the type of adoption you're dealing with, where the child is from, the law of the state, where the parent or child are located, and some other factors. So it's important to consult with the family law attorneys. Foster parents sometimes will adopt their foster children, but the fostering process doesn't necessarily require legal representation. A lot of times that could be done on your own. So lawyers practicing family law, they can represent people in family court proceedings and settlement and negotiations and settlement agreements for family court legal issues. So when you think about it, family law attorneys really deal with problems that encompass many aspects of the family life. And so lawyers in this field, they help all kinds of people sort of facing all kinds of sensitive issues that many people wouldn't immediately assume goes under the family law umbrella. Now, so far, I have not mentioned anything about the elderly, have I? This is where elder law comes in. And elder law attorneys really are advocates for the elderly and their loved ones. Most elder law attorneys handle a wide range of legal matters that affect an older person or even a disabled person. And these types of matters can include things like health care, you know, long-term care planning, guardianship, and other important issues. So again, just to sort of run through a list of some of the things an elder law attorney can help with. Wills and trust is part of good estate planning, including planning for a minor that may have special needs. They can talk to the clients about what probate is all about and how can we avoid probate, for example, with a revocable trust. They can talk about creating powers of attorney, financial powers of attorney, healthcare surrogate designations, living wills, provide help with healthcare planning, including getting somebody qualified for Medicaid to pay for long-term care. Again, as I mentioned, guardianships, maybe helping locate suitable long-term care facilities and explaining a nursing home resident's rights. And maybe if those rights are violated, helping to file nursing home claims. Now, importantly, I listed a lot of different sort of undertakings that are done in elder law, it doesn't mean that every elder law attorney will do all of those, okay? So it's important that you find an elder law attorney that has experience in your area of concern. For example, it's quite common if an elder law attorney is going to handle sort of the planning side, they're not going to be bringing lawsuits against nursing homes. That's more of what a litigator would do. So in many ways, elder law attorneys, think of them as specialists because of their focus on the needs of older adults, which really often are different and more focused and specific than the needs of younger adults. So not only can elder law attorneys sort of handle important financial and estate planning matters, but again, think of it as being able to handle the day-to-day issues affecting the actual care that seniors receive, assisted living, life planning, and so forth. So, hey, if you'd like to know a little bit more about the difference between a family law and elder law, and maybe how we can help you, we'd love to talk to you. So to make it really easy to take that first step, we invite you to go ahead and schedule a free phone call. We don't charge for it. We call it our discovery phone call. It's a way to start the conversation, and we make it as easy as possible to schedule it. So we have a scheduling link. If you go to the bottom of this video, there's a scheduling link. Click on it. Takes you to our scheduling tool. Just pick the time that works for you, and we'll jump on the call with you. If you'd also like to know some more, we have a growing volume of YouTube videos on our YouTube channel, Legacy Planning Law Group. We invite you to subscribe. If you've enjoyed this video, we'd ask that you like it. And if you're so willing, share it with your friends. So Bill O'Leary signing off for now. Go make it a great day and a better world.